to witness Josh Levine Speaks History, my first unboxing video at 51 years old. It's about time I unbox something, isn't it? Now, seriously, because of the success of my record player reviews and my guitar reviews, people have been contacting me about sending me products to try for my opinion. That is nuts. So anyway, the great folks at Angel's Horn have sent me this record player combo with speakers to check out, and I'm honored and I'm psyched to try this out. So let's go get it. I'm tripping over chords here, people. Just like it's so real. This is real. This has never been opened. Original tape. Angel's Horn, we're gonna get. Check it out. Alright. I know what you guys are all wondering. Always make sure you have proper tools to open things. That's why I always have a flathead screwdriver to open cardboard boxes. You think they suck money in here? Oh, by the way, no bribes were paid. This is all real. Okay, they already won me. They got that fancy box on the inside. Fancy box on the inside, and I already like the look. It's kind of cool, isn't it? All right. I hope you're allowed to do this. It doesn't say this end up, so I found this table is really the perfect table for this, Vince. All right. And so you know, I'm not making it up. You're gonna love this. It was sent to Josh Levine Speaks. Oh wait, that could mean I just bought it on Amazon. I promise you, I didn't. They sent it to me for free. This is crazy. All right. Oh, we have it upside down. Very realistic. Is that right side up? All right, it says, visit their website, fancy new box. Hey, at Angel's Horn, check it out on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. Wait, they have other people doing this? Okay, now I'm mad. All right. It says, renewed vibrations. All right. Has it got the sexy picture of it on there? It's super. My initial impression is mid-century modern. This is going to look nice in your house already. So even if it ends up being a piece of furniture, it's nice. All right. Again, be very careful when you cut open electronics that you have a very sharp flathead screwdriver. I am kidding. Please use a knife. All right. It's packed really well. Can't wait to see what's inside. By the way, I don't know if you know this, but I owned a music store for a decade, and I've unpacked every kind of electronic device there is. This is really well packed. And my initial impression, oh boy, here we go. Well, it passed the drop test already, so that's pretty cool. Very authentic so far, isn't it? All right, I have a cord thing. Oh, by the way, I will not be reading instructions while doing this, because I just don't, unless I need to put this belt on. Now, if that's the case, we will be putting a belt on, but that might be an extra. My hope is that's an extra. I didn't know I was gonna have work to do. I thought I was gonna open a box and play. But hey, let's get everything out. Hey, it's got a quick startup guide that looks actually fairly simple. Again, I'm not gonna read too much, although it looks like I actually have to install stuff. This could be a long video. Vince, you're going to have to cut through all this stuff. All right, let's do it. I should have known. A record player would not be... I once sold at auction a really... I believe the company's name was Soda. And I sold this at an auction. It wasn't new. It was a record player and it sold for several thousand dollars. And the best part about it was... All right, the platter is separate and weighs a ton, which is good. With electronic equipment, that's a rule, right? Am I right? The heavier it is, the better it is. That used to be a rule of thumb when we were buying secondhand stuff. It really is. If you're buying secondhand and you've never heard of the maker model and you pick it up and it weighs a ton, it's probably good. It's probably expensive. Oh, back to my soda story. I believe it was called the Soda Sapphire. Don't hold me to that. That just kind of rings well. Soda Saturn, soda something. And what it was, oh, look at all these fragilities. Fragile, it doesn't say that. I sold this record player and this high-end audio equipment on eBay, knew nothing about it, never heard of the brands before. Kind of like this brand, I had never heard of this till now. But now you're gonna know it everywhere because Josh Levine speaks as marketing for them. So look at this. So anyway, long story short, the record player sold for about $1,500 second hand, and a gentleman said, I don't want you to ship it until I send you a box. And he said, a box will be coming from the manufacturer for you to use to ship. And I said, okay. I said, how much was the box? And he said, $400. And I said, why? He goes, because it's a very elaborate box. When it came, it took me 2 days to pack the turntable because you have to secure all of these components. And with this thing, it was a little, I can't use the word I want to say, a little crazy. I already like the feel of the table, I can tell you. It feels like it has stabilizers, which is really kind of cool. Which will be come in handy if you haven't noticed, because I'm kind of clumsy, and if I knock something over, it'll be stable. And I have a brand new record that I'm going to put on it today. Well, I'm just kidding. I actually bought a record for this at Walmart. Not sponsoring Walmart today. They won't sponsor me. I don't know what's up with that. Because I'm totally Walmart, if you haven't noticed. I bet you were thinking I was Target. I'm not. Okay, here we go. I removed this. I'm not following the instructions. I will look. You have all these parts? I got all those parts. Platter? Oh, it's on there. It's there. See, it's already there for me. And I feel a belt. I think the belt's already on it, so I'm pretty excited about that. Although it says belt. Dare I? I'm gonna look. Oh. I need to put a belt on. All right, we can do this. We have the technology. It's in this bag. Or this bag. Do, 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 do. All right. Has everyone had as much coffee as I have? No? All right. Let's see. Oh yeah, I'm gonna look at this. I promised I wasn't. So I'm not really looking. Does it go on the outside of this? Oh, it does, it does. So you put this on, and then, wait a second. I would think the belt would go, and then this would go. Maybe I have to look at the instructions. Let's see. Yes, yes, okay. This part is not super clear, but I get it. Belt goes on, I'm assuming. And then you put it down, and then it says to take your finger and go this way. Or I'm upside down, so yes. But it's doing what it's supposed to do, so we like that. All right, next up, it's the platter. Dum, dum, dum. And like I told you, this is no slouch. I've had some platters on some less expensive models that, let's say, you know, if someone gave you the Captain America with this, it would be a bad day. All right, so here's for branding. Who's branding? I don't know. Let's go. Oh, wait, first, am I putting this on right? It says top, top, yes, yes, okay. All right. I see in one of the instructions coming up, it says something about careful. So, as we've seen, okay, that's on. Oh, careful, okay and not okay. Okay touching, not okay touching. Right here. All right, so something to do with the back, oh, it's the counterweight. So I'm gonna put the weight on and turn it that way. It goes that way, but not that way. Okay, well, let's see what happens. Oh, I see. It's threaded. It's the weight for the tone arm. Again, I think I got this figured out. Looks pretty good. I'm gonna trust it. I think I got it. Yep. All right. Now, ooh, fancy Dan. Now I'm putting on the plastic cover. All right. I know when you saw this, you thought we were gonna go to a buffet, right? You were at the buffet. I was at the buffet. Okay. That was my worst joke of the day. There will be worse. Oh, the thing on the front? It didn't tell me to touch that yet, so I'm gonna trust it. Yeah, no, on the needle. Let's see. Pop, pop. Oh, I like that. All right. Hey, there's all sorts of buttons and stuff down here. We're gonna find out about those in a minute, I'm sure. All right, so connections to speakers. You know, this isn't as complicated as I thought. I was gonna kinda guess it wouldn't be. I wonder why it repeats itself next. Ah, here's the thing about operations and stuff. We'll figure that out. All right, we're gonna get these speakers hooked up. All right, speaker. Again, don't let the small size fool you. I'm, you know, normally in the old days, when I was a junior rocker, you know, high school, and I would have saw these speakers and been like, oh, they can't be any good. And then Bose showed us that that doesn't mean anything. They have a nice look, and it's a satin finish, but they feel really good. I don't know if you know a lot of wood like this, it'll just be rough sanded or like, it has like a satin finish. And that new car smell. It's got new car smell too. So it's pretty cool. And I'm serious. This is my first time I've ever done an unboxing video. If this was really at home, I would have broken everything so far. Or gotten frustrated by something. Let's see. There's been no edits yet. Right, Vince? We're right in order. I didn't have to redo anything yet. Speaker cords. Now it's going to get interesting. First off, I'm going to say the gauge of the speaker wire is a little thin. I bet you could upgrade your speaker wire, but I'm just saying, throwing it out there. Because this is authentic. This is my real opinion. All right. Hey, they're red and black. That's always a plus. Just trying to explain to somebody that the white line down the side of the black one means the ground, and what that could be is red and black. You can't go wrong. On the back of the speaker, if I can get in here, let's see. The red, push the doohickey in. That's the professional term for this. Doohickey. Oh, wait. You know what I'm going to mess up? This is my right speaker. And on the back, same thing. If it's the first time you're using one of these push-in, these little locking speaker wires, always make sure that you're on the metal contact. Sometimes you'll put it off the side, you'll stick it in and it'll lock in place, and you'll be like, it's broken. And then you find out it's just not making contact metal on metal. So just take a look and make sure that it's on the metal. I say that because the 8-year-old boy in me that got a new stereo from Radio Shack, of course, the finest quality. Radio Shack got an old RCA player, and I didn't do it right, and I thought it was broken, took it back to the store, made a big 8-year-old scene about it, how he ruined my Christmas, and then it turned out he goes, you have to put it in like this. So, I remembered from there on. All right, unlike, and also do this when it's not turned on and powered up, unless you like the sound of, it's a great sound effect. All right, we have speakers. I'm assuming power. I'm not gonna even look at the manual, watch at me. I'm gonna do this all myself. Uh-oh, Vince. We may have a problem. I know I got an outlet over there. This cord is looking a little challenging in length. This is our first edit. We're back, we're live. We're back, we're live, we have power. All right, stand back. I am going to plug this in. Maybe I'm going to remove, before I plug this in, I'm going to remove the tape that is protecting the stylus. The Phono cartridge. And that's why I wanted to be careful. Aha. Oh, is that a protector? Oh, that's just the protector. Oh my goodness. I got scared there for a second. Thought I pulled the whole thing off. Wait a second. I might have pulled the whole thing off. Did I? Or is that just the protector? Nope. I pulled the whole thing off. But that's okay. It looks like it's an Audio Technica. You know what? I'm going to look at an instruction first because I have a feeling it tells me what to do. All right. Slide that off. Turn the tone arm. Could it be? There's nowhere for that to go in. Maybe it does just sit there. Is that possible? That's new to me. We'll see. I could do that. Oh no, that can't be. Let's see. Oh no. I didn't break it, I promise. And it didn't say careful at that point. Is it possible that that just rides on there? I think it is. Maybe that's the high tech part. Let's see. All right, have I made a mess? All right, I'm gonna look one more time. I'm looking. The okay, not okay, I got past. I got past all that stuff. I safely made it here. It said slide that plastic cover off, which I did. And then I removed all that stuff. Yeah, it doesn't say anything about it popping in. It doesn't say anything about that. I think it's ready. But what I'm gonna do is what I like to call a little record player test. Make sure I have everything set up properly. Oh, first I'm going to turn it on. On switch is in the back. It is on. I'm going to turn the volume on first. I'm going to raise this arm because I believe it's an automatic. No? Speed. Did I not? Oh. Ready? You know, the first question they're going to ask you is, did you check to see if the electric cord was plugged in? Cable company, every time. Is your modem plugged in? Yes. Well, it wasn't plugged in. So, now we're plugged in. Now we're turned on. Now let's see what happens. I might have to look at the manual. Can you imagine the embarrassment? Yes. Operation. Little turn. Oh, what's that do? Has anyone ever seen this before? Oh, it's on now. Okay. Bad power cord. Ergo, it's not going to make any sound. There it is. All right. Should you be like me and not read instructions? It clearly says exactly how to install the needle in here. See that? My mom always said, follow the instructions. Did you follow the instructions? Did you see if it was plugged in? Have we learned very valuable lessons in this so far? Am I embarrassed? Not in the slightest. Okay. So, moment of truth. This is the most important thing. Is how does it work? What does it sound like? So far, everything's good. Everything feels like it's built really well. You know, I don't even know the price point of this, so I don't care. I just want to see if it's a good record player. You know, audiophiles, record players are coming back in vogue. Everything's super cool. Cassettes are coming back too. Hey, Angel's Horn, maybe you're making a new cassette player you want to send me. And I promise you this time it won't take me 2 months to make a video for you. So, today we're going to play Daughtry. Now, am I a big fan of Daughtry? No. Do I think he's okay? Yeah. He was number 7 American Idol, right? Number 7, something like that. Smart move, by the way. But he kind of rocks. He's got a good voice. I got this for Christmas because my wife thought I said I wanted... I can't even remember the band, but it was like not even close. This is like Rage Against the Machine. Okay? But it was funny. But she also got me Kiss Destroyer sealed, which is that's all that matters, you know. So, all right. So Daughtry, this was a factory sealed record. It is no longer factory sealed, lowering the value. Has authentic sleeve action. All right. The question is, what song are we going to listen to? Actually, we're not going to listen to much. We'll probably have to blank this. I don't know how that works. Are we allowed to play what we?
15 seconds.
15 seconds. Okay. You can listen to this for 15 seconds. All right. It's not Roger Daughtry. It's Daughtry. Right. Yeah. All right. Cage the Rattle. You know what? Let's just start with track number one. So what you do is you raise your tone, raise your arms, people. All right. It's a 33. I had it set on 45. I slide the needle over. It's automatic, as you can see. Oh, I'm going to lower this bad boy on here. Let's see. Make sure I'm lined up. Okay, that's all we can listen to of that, right, Vince? Well, no, I'm going to go a little further because I want to hear something. That sounds pretty good. It's clean. I like the sound quality. I like it's clean. It's not super loud. So, I don't know what the wattage output. It has a built-in preamp, so that's where the sound is coming from. So, but compared to those Crosleys and those other portables that are on the market today, the sound is far superior. But the volume, if you're looking for something to blast and knock the walls down, you probably need to add a preamp. But I like how clean the sound is for, if you know, record players. There's not a lot of scratch. There's not a lot of, it's probably that great cartridge it has, the one I was messing with. Audio Technica makes great cartridges in all price points. And it sounded really good. I'm going to go to another track so we don't have an issue with licensing. So, in my opinion, it's a great basic. You want to learn about record players. You want maybe the nostalgia, get your kids back listening to record players. This is really cool. By the way, that's super fun to go to the thrift stores and the yard sales and go get old records and bring them home. I've been doing it with my daughter and she like super loves it. It's fun, especially if you find those old. And the sound quality of this is far superior to the one I picked up at a thrift store. I picked up a Crosley. It just sounds really good. What would take it to the next level, I think, is running it into a real preamp, like a tube preamp, and another system. The player itself, the tone arm feels good. Like I said, the platter feels good. You know, overall, I'm impressed. Thank you guys for sending it. And if I'm allowed to keep it, if you're mad at me because it took me a couple of months to make this video, I will pack it up and send it back up. Although I don't know if I'll figure out how to get it back in the box. And number two, there was something else. I want my kid to have this one instead of the one we have at home. All right, thanks. This was Josh from Josh Levine Speaks. My first unboxing video, that was called unboxing, you know, MMA style, unboxing. So It was my first video, and I thought it was all right. It went okay. We even had like real life problems, like not reading instructions, not having your power turn, and not plugging it in, and then when you do, not turning on the power strip, and then when you do that, jiggling it. And it had nothing to do with this. Everything came out of the box, everything works. Instructions were 95% clear, except for that thing with the belt. It just didn't tell you to loop it on the motor, but kind of obvious. But not so, but you'll know from this video. Thank you guys so much. I really appreciate it. Josh from Josh Levine Speaks. Now, somebody needs to put this stuff away.
That was really cheesy, but I liked it.